someone asked me about my kit, so I'm going to go over it real quick for you here. DW, I love them. It happens to be my initials, Dana Wade. So that's initially what drew me to them, because I can have my initials right on the front there. Nobody knows. They think it's me, because nobody knows who DW is. But anyway, I have, I love green. Green's my favorite color. So I actually had the, I picked this out, had it custom made. It's the Collector Series. It's more of a fusion type setup because I have an 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 inch toms, and they're all birch, so I, you know, I get up a lot of attack. My snare, I've got a nice deep metal snare here, and this happens to be a pearl snare, but it has a really good sound to it. And what I like to do, my technique for this is, with a metal snare you get a lot of ring and a lot of tint and all that kind of stuff. And so what I'll do is I'll put heavy heads on. I got a controlled sound head on here, and Rezzo head's about the same. But I'll crank it up and it just has a nice crack to it. You know, I mean, a nice thick snare head with the metal. With the metal snare, it just makes a nice cracking sound. Along with the birch, my drums have a lot of attack. I also use the octobalance because I like to start high here and there, 6-inch. All Evans heads, they tend to like those a lot. My cymbals, I like bright cymbals. You look around, I don't have a lot of deep sounding cymbals or anything. A lot of thin 16-inch crashes. I got most of them are 15 and 16 inches. You know, and I ride quarter notes on a lot over here, so I usually have some kind of custom cymbal, and I like them real short, so there's not a lot of overring. That's why I like the brightness and all that. Bad thing is, I use sticks like this, Rock Vader, really big sticks. They're long, and I break a lot of cymbals, but they honor them up to 2 years, so I usually get 2 for 1. You know, I mail them back, they'll give me another one. A lot of people ask me about my stack cymbals here. Mike Portnoy, I mean, he designed them, he started with all that. And these happen to be his designs here. Here we have the Mag Stack, and this is the 10-inch one. This is the 12-inch, it's got a 14-inch cymbal under it. And this one has a 10-inch splash cymbal on it with a China Kang on top. And it just gives a really cool sound. I don't know if you guys can hear it, but it's like a real short. Again, I like the, real fast, short type things going on. This is the ride that I was actually on. I was on a band called Crimson Glory. This actual ride is very old, 30 years old. It was on the Transcendence record, and it's going to be on the Persuasive Reason record as well. Of course, it's down a hi-hat, and I got a lot of cymbals around, and people ask me, you don't use it all? Yeah, I use this whole kit. When I play, I use everything. I wouldn't have this stuff if I didn't use it. This stack here, you can make your own. You don't have to pay because these are very expensive from Mike Portnoy. I got cheaper cymbals. I got a crash, 16-inch, 15-inch crash, and a 14-inch mini China on top of that. And again, that makes a nice. It's a little. You can hear the different sounds all. And I love the sounds of Chinas like that, you know? Really cool. And just a little China Kang here. Just gives that sound. I usually like to have it around the ride here so I can kind of, do a groove and pop it in there. Love the little Zill bell here. It's from Zildjian, and this thing just will just, that'll be ringing, for a while. And then, an old tambourine, I just once in a while stick that in here and there just for fun, and once in a while I'll kick that in. And of course, I usually have some kind of large China. I'm not too picky about that. A little splash over here. I like to hit this with my left. I like the hybrid, and this thing's very old. I beat it up and beat it up and beat it up, and it's still hanging in there. And you're probably looking at a lot of my cymbals thinking, wow, why doesn't he polish them all up? I would suggest never polish your cymbals. It just ruins them, So. I use them, I take what I get, sometimes it gets a little green if they hang in there. I usually break cymbals, go through cymbals so fast, so they don't stay dirty long. I usually have to throw them out. I mean, you get a little thicker one, this guy's been around, he's getting a little green, but he still sounds great. This is how they all start out, all beautiful, but again, I suggest if you have cymbals, don't polish them. You're just going to hurt the sound. My kit, the first thing TJ said as we were going to record is get the gel stuff. We got to mute the draw toms and all that. Not true. If you tune your drums good, you don't need any mute. You don't need any tape on them. You don't do anything live. I don't have any of that stuff. I'm just really good at tuning the drums, and you can get that way too. If you can go online and find helpful hints on how to tune your drums. But if you do them right, there's no mute. There's nothing on those, and they're just tuned really well, and it just, you know, makes a great sounding kit. So hopefully that answered some of your questions about, you know, what I'm all about back here. But that's my setup, that's my deal, and see you on the road.